What do movies and graveyards have in common?
What?
Plot.
Not all movies.
It's true.
Hey, welcome back to our Stupid Rags and Idiots. I'm Corbin.
I'm Rick.
Hi. Also, Instagram, Twitter, for more juicy content.
It's follow so us on juicy.
Instagram and Twitter.
Right. Also, on personal YouTube.
Juicy.
God.
Regular trailer. Dropped 4 days ago, something like that. It's a Hindi film, Netflix. It's called Pajlayat.
Pajlayat. Compared to Paj regular. Pajlayat is if you're on a diet. Why do I always go to Billy Crystal?
I have no idea.
Me too. Pajlayat, official trailer. Sanya Malhotra, Sayani Gupta, and Ashutosh Rana.
Also, you go to Billy Crystal's impression.
Yes.
Of a Jewish man.
True, but Billy Crystal's Jewish. So
yeah, but that's not his voice.
Nah, but it's an extension of his. It's always the Princess Bride. You know, when Sandhya's husband suffers an untimely death, just a few months into their marriage, that sucks, a slew of revelations forces her to re-examine her priorities and make some hard decisions. Pajlayat is the journey of a young widow as she learns how to free her crazy, that's the sentence, comma, face the family and find herself. It's an upcoming Indian Hindi language comedy drama film written and directed by Umesh Bist. The film stars an ensemble cast including Sanya Malhotra, Dangal, Ludo, Ashutosh Rana, Mulk, Shiva Chadha, Gully Boy, Badai Ho, Sayana Gupta, Article 15, Raghabar Yadav, Lagan and Newton, Rajesh Talang, Mirzapur, Delhi Crime, Asif Khan, Patalok, and many other brilliant actors. What an ensemble. The film is also the debut of Arjit Singh as music composer.
Oh.
Cool.
That's his first time composing.
Wow. I didn't realize that.
Well, that's very exciting. Hope it's
man.
Good. So, that's good. Good on Netflix getting a good cast together.
Seriously.
Here we need to make sure the CC is around there. Here we go.
Astik naam tha 5 mahine pehle tohi ki shaadi. Sandhya, theek hai?
Theek hai.
Aap sabko usi ki fikr hai bas.
Thought it was Tapsley for a second.
Vijay saab ko pata hai, aapka ladka guzar gaya. Isiliye 20% discount pehle se kaat ke diya hai.
नियम से रहना है पीवी का सिगरेट शराब गुटखा सब बंद
चाय भी चलते
अम्मा हम चाय नहीं पीएंगे एक पेप्सी मंगवा दीजिए
बीच नदी में चलेंगे विसर्जन करने
पंडित जी बोटिंग करने थोड़ी आए हैं
स्थान
फेसबुक से पता चला यार स्नेह ने पोस्ट किया था
235 कमेंट्स हैं
क्या हो रहा है सुन तुम ऐसे क्यों बिहेव कर रही हो जैसे कुछ हुआ ही नहीं
वो आस्तिक गिरी जी ने हमारी कंपनी से लाइफ इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसी ली थी उन्होंने 50 लाख का इंश्योरेंस करवाया था सिंगल नॉमिनी है उनकी धर्म पत्नी संध्या गिरी
संध्या बिटिया चाहे तो सेकंड मैरिज कर सकती है चाहे घर का पैसा डर नहीं रहे
अगर हम अपने फैसले खुद ही लेंगे ना तो दूसरे ले लेंगे
Okay.
Of course, a fart joke at the end is gonna make us.
Not only am I thrilled that that's part of the film. That they made that the end of the teaser, the trailer.
Just the grandma ripping one. That's funny.
I'm in. Just for grandma ripping one.
One, also for the filmmakers as well. That, and I do remember the lead actress for sure.
Absolutely. I recognize a bunch of the faces, but for sure. What did we last see her in?
Ludo.
That's right.
It was Ludo. Ludo's son.
Looks good.
It does look good.
It looks like it's going to be both make you laugh and make you cry.
Mixture of like funny of like Ludo, but also like the family drama of Badai Ho in it. Even though if it's as funny as, because I loved Ludo. Ludo was a
great film.
Fantastic combination of
comedy,
drama, and obviously really good acting by a bunch of different people.
Yeah.
I love, how often are these films made? Is it more now because of OTT platforms that there's not a big star in this?
Mm-hmm.
There's no massive star. There's a bunch of people that are known and have been around, but there's not like a Ranveer. No. There's not like a Shah Rukh Khan. There's not a Shahid. There's not even a Raj Kumar. But this is like a big ensemble cast of just looks like a bunch of really good actors, and it looks like a fun, good story.
It's one of the beauties of OTT platforms, mm-hmm. I think, comparatively. And I read a story recently that said, is Tom Hanks the last big movie star, per se? That is a draw by name, as it were. Because the beautiful thing about an OTT platform is you don't have to have a name draw like you do for a motion picture and theater releases. Because more people are likely to watch something simply by recommendation or just scrolling. And they want to find something to watch.
And they'll watch it.
They're not going to go in and go look for a star name and then find the film. They're just going to look on what's trending, what's popular, and that's what they're going to watch on an OTT platform.
Thankfully, and that's changing, I think, almost in every industry, the fact that even though you still have your stars, obviously you're never not going to have your stars.
You're never not going to have stars.
But hopefully all those stars are looking for just good films.
Correct.
Now, and because I think it's changed, because it used to be just put the star in this film.
Yes.
It's good. Put the star in the show, and people will watch it.
Yes.
Now people know, like, if we get a good story,
yeah,
there's almost no stars in Game of Thrones until later, obviously, because of Game of Thrones, they became stars.
I think that the impact of the OTT platform is even bigger than the impact that cable had, because cable completely changed the landscape of television. Because prior to cable, you were either a TV star or a movie star, and it was always a step up from TV to film. And if you stepped down, it was like, what did happen to their career? Why did they stop making... Ew, they're not... You left TV and went to film. Now, movie stars want to be in TV shows.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
like a big deal to be in a TV show because the quality is so good now.
Just as good, if not better, a lot
exactly.
of times. And you can flesh out your character a lot more.
But the OTTs
also,
give
I have
us
no
international
what,
connectivity.
What that article is talking about, the last... There's a ton of stars that aren't Tom Hanks. I don't know.
They're talking about box office draw.
There's a ton. Leonardo DiCaprio.
He doesn't draw like Tom Hanks used to. Back in the day, during Forrest Gump, Castaway.
I can name 10
that are popular films.
But no, like popular actors that have the draw, if not more so than Tom Hanks.
Today.
Yeah.
Not then.
No, I'm saying.
Yeah, like the days back in the 90s, Tom Hanks, Harrison Ford, Meryl Streep at the time they just released a film and it was going to be a huge success.
Oh, yeah. There's those.
Yeah, and that's what they mean. And
I don't agree
the landscape, the landscape of entertainment there was no OTT platform. There was no cable television. Mm-hmm. These were movie stars that you could only see when you went to the movies, and that's what was the big draw at the time. And everybody's attention was undivided.
Tom Hanks should do a show.
Yeah, I would love to see. Do you pop quiz? What was Tom Hanks's claim to fame? There you go.
That's an easy one.
Not for everybody.
I think all those stars should. You can go on HBO because obviously a lot of your films are going there anyway. Like Leo, Brad Pitt, like Tom Hanks, all these.
Al Pacino.
All these people.
Constantly doing TV.
Yeah. There's no difference now.
Yep.
So just do it.
Yeah.
Like, wait, Tom Hardy's on one of the best shows, like, in the past, like, 10 years in Peaky Blinders. And it's an amazing show.
Yeah.
So these
are definitely well-known names, but yeah, they're not the big stars, and I love it. I'm interested. This looks like it's going to be funny, and it's going to make you cry. It looks good.
So let us know what you thought about it.
down. Blip. Dadin dinda tin tin da dadin dinda tin tin da dina di dina tina di dina din tuk dina tuna katta dak dak dina din tin da din tin da tuk tuna katta tin da tuk dina tuk ma ka chaw.